Children's hospitals have been called the backbone of pediatric care in the U.S. They're a relatively small percentage of the healthcare arena, making up just about 5% of all hospitals in the country. However, they are part of this ongoing boom, as some call it, of hospital expansion and reconstruction projects throughout the U.S. And that's happening here locally as well. The new Golisano Children's Hospital will open its doors in a matter of days. It serves more than 74,000 kids across the region each year. And my guest, Dr. Nina Schor, pediatrician-in-chief at the hospital, says there is nothing like it anywhere else in upstate New York. So as the hospital expands, how has its vision, role, and purpose expanded? Joining me for this discussion, Dr. Nina Schor, and it's great to have you on the program.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Thank you. Well, as I quoted in that intro, you said there's nothing else like this hospital in upstate. Tell me a little bit about the details of this facility that make it a standout.
Well, so it is a uniquely children's hospital. I think as you walk in the doors, the first thing that hits you is that you're not in Kansas anymore. This is, without a doubt, a hospital designed to be perfect as an environment for children, for families, for siblings of children who are ill, who need to feel welcome to this environment as well. So visually and contextually, it is a unique environment. I think for me as a pediatrician, the thing that is the most inviting about this environment is that we thought long and hard and with children who have particular disabilities, how do we make an environment inviting and welcoming for a child who can't see or a child who can't hear or for a family that has motor disabilities? How do we welcome them in the door and say, you belong here too? So I think that's the very first impression kind of difference about this environment.
And then beyond the first impression, was there, I guess, a point where there were there key indicators that you used or that the team used or that leaders at the medical center used to say, you know, these upgrades and these changes, it's not a should, it's a matter of we must do this?
Without a doubt.
And what were those?
I think the most obvious one was every year during flu season, as our capability of distinguishing one strain of flu from another, our molecular diagnostics ability improved, it became clear that we could actually do better for children, first of all, by having them in private rooms and not having to worry about, is this child gonna infect the child in the next bed? Mm-hmm. But, you know, years ago, you would just put two kids with flu in the same room mm-hmm. and not worry about it. And now it's very clear that if the strain that they're infected with is not exactly the same, they could infect one another and make that flu each worse for the other child. And so now having completely private rooms, we're not having in the middle of the night to genotype everybody's flu virus and say, do I have to move this child at 2 a.m. because a child coming up from the emergency room has a different strain of flu?
Very interesting. Well, for more than 10 years, the Golisano Children's Hospital under the University of Rochester umbrella has been named after the family of Rochester entrepreneur and philanthropist Tom Golisano. He pledged $20 million for the expansion. And I have a little video clip of what he had to say about the new hospital at this summer's groundbreaking. And we'll take a look, and viewers can also then get an inside peek at the hospital as well.
The cards, the letters, the phone calls, the stopping me on the street of people that come up to me and say, Tom, the hospital's just done a wonderful job for our child, and without it, we don't know what we could have done. So now what we have here today is even now a bigger extension of that. More people are gonna come to this hospital from neighboring communities, I'm sure. I heard a wise man say it. He said, the only wealth that you get to keep is that which you give away. The only wealth you get to keep is that which you give away. And I know someday I'm not going to be here, and some of the family members won't be here, but this building will be here. And that's our ongoing wealth.
Dr. Schor, Tom Golisano said that this facility will really allow the hospital to expand its reach even more so than it's currently been doing. Has there been an increasing demand in terms of patient referrals from other healthcare facilities in the upstate area that are unable to adequately treat young people 17 and under?
Yes, in two very, very important ways, I think. It has now become, I think, the capabilities of what we are able to do medically for children who many, many years ago would have succumbed to chronic disease. That comes at a price, an economic price. And so a small community hospital with perhaps 5 or 10 pediatric beds really can't afford to provide the technological advances for that small a number of children. It really is a matter of economies of scale that you build when you centralize those kinds of resources. The additional thing is that we, as a children's hospital, have started to realize that there were many, many children and families who had to relocate to larger cities to get what they needed. And now that many of the smaller hospitals around us are saying, you know what, we just as soon leave the high-end pediatric care to you, we can now provide those things that families used to go elsewhere for.
Well, if this new facility is intended to help produce improved health outcomes for kids, what changes are you expecting to see? And how will you know if this new facility is in fact contributing to some of those changes?
Uh-huh. We have for many years now invested very, very heavily in monitoring of health outcomes. And we do that in several ways. The immediate way is to look at infection control and to look at outcomes while a child is in the hospital, to look at patient and family satisfaction. We now do much more than that. We survey families once they go home from the hospital. We survey our community pediatricians to say, how are we doing? What can we do better to provide you with what you need for a child when they're back in your care and back at home? This children's hospital will allow us to educate families in a way we never could, because a parent now can stay very comfortably in the room with the child. And because the room is a private room, they won't feel as intimidated to ask questions, because there won't be another family on the other side of a curtain. We think that that is going to be a game changer in terms both of family satisfaction and in terms of longer term outcomes for that child when they get home. The way we'll know is that we will continue to do this monitoring and surveying and see if an inflection point in the outcomes occurs right at the moment when that move was made to the new hospital.
You know, it's interesting in my reading, we hear that the role of children's hospitals, it's definitely expanding. And it's no longer just about admitting, treating, and discharging sick patients, but now more so, hospitals can actually serve as advocates for the well-being of kids. And I want to know, is there anything that you think with this new facility where the hospital will be ahead of the curve?
Yeah, it is interesting. Certainly ahead of the curve regionally, being able to do more in the way of cardiac transplantation eventually, being able to treat children and tide them over during the period when a heart is recovering rather than sending them somewhere else to have that done. But I think the thing that makes me proudest was really facilitated and highlighted by the hospital, but will take place throughout this community, not just in the four walls of the hospital. And that is that because we are now capable so much better than years ago to keep children not just alive through chronic illness, but well and contributing and participating in communities, we will get them on that path in the hospital. But our hospital is now constructed knowing that we will have failed if we don't teach families and children to make that transition into adulthood and to continue to take care of their health when their health is in their own hands. And I think the thing that makes me the happiest about that and that puts us way ahead of the national curve is the plans that we're now making to transition children from childhood with chronic illness to productive adulthood.
Well, I want to close with this. We reached out to Tom Golisano regarding the opening of the new children's hospital this month, and he had a few words that he wanted us to share for him. And he said, 4 years ago, I made a commitment, along with many others in the community, to build a new next-generation, state-of-the-art Golisano Children's Hospital that would keep pace with medical and technological advancements and modern standards. And build we did. It's spectacular in every way, from the building to the services provided inside to the hospital's entire staff, who does a remarkable job providing the highest quality health care to our children. My family and I, we are honored to be associated with the vital life-saving care and support that is helping our children and their families every day. And with that, Dr. Nina Schor, Pediatrician-In-Chief at the Golisano Children's Hospital, I appreciate your time today. Thank you.
Thank you.
And you can learn more about the new hospital and its services. Check out the website on your screen, urmc.rochester.edu/children's-hospital. And for full disclosure, the Thomas Golisano Production Center is located at WXXI.